Gold Hydrogen Managing Director Neil McDonald joins me in the studio now to discuss what he describes as amazing hydrogen and helium results. Neil, good to see you.
Yeah, good morning. How are you today?
I'm good, good, Neil. And how are you?
Yeah, all very good. We're very happy with how we're all progressing at the moment, and may it all continue. It's looking quite positive.
So let's talk through recent results. Now, you've confirmed natural hydrogen up to 86% purity and helium up to 17.5% at Ramsay. Take us through those numbers, what they mean, and not only for the company, but globally as well, they're significant.
Yeah, look, thank you. It's fantastic results, and we're very pleased to have found and confirmed not only 86% natural hydrogen results from Ramsay 1, Ramsay 2, more particularly for those results, but the helium is just globally world-class at 17.5%. And we're surprised, but we're not shocked by that. Globally, most helium comes from petroleum-producing wells, and this is a non-petroleum-producing system. And there's a few other helium explorers out there specifically looking for helium in a non-petroleum system like this. And I think we'll see some better results as well from the industry. But this is up there. Commercially, helium is viable from 1% purity upwards, let alone having 17.5. And for the helium and the hydrogen, so we're done stage one testing at the moment. And what's happened there is it's great to see that both gases are coming out of the formation and being found at surface. So we're getting both helium and hydrogen out of our test zones into the wellbore, and it's migrating to surface, flowing to surface. So that's really, really good early news for stage one, and we're still going to come back and do stage two.
Neil, I think it's worth highlighting here that it is the early stages of testing. It's only just begun, really.
That's correct. So this is all about the stage one. What we're doing at the moment is to test the zones, get as many samples as possible. This is the first time this has ever been done in Australia, and to be honest, really up there, it's the second time in the world to specifically look for natural hydrogen and also helium in the one system. So we're getting as many samples as possible. They're all getting sent to the laboratory as we speak, and that includes world-leading laboratories in Paris, London, and Australia, with CSIRO also looking after some of our samples. And because it's a unique system, we're going to do a lot of composition and analysis of those results and then finish our testing of this, the stage one testing after Easter. And hopefully we'll be reporting some very good natural hydrogen results as well from those zones that we're yet to complete. And then wrap up stage one testing and then move to stage two.
And all this data that's being collected, it's all leading to the construction of a pilot plant.
It is. So stage two testing will involve coming back and using existing techniques and equipment to be able to lift some of the fluids that we have coming to the well, which is good news for geologists and reservoir engineers to get fluid and gases into the surface. It shows that it's very permeable and the formation is good. So this is standard behavior, standard practice. We'll lift the gases, we'll flow natural hydrogen and helium, and we wish to progress to that pilot program. And that will involve on-site, we're looking to do electricity generation from the hydrogen, put into separators to separate the hydrogen and the helium. And we'll power, the local area, prove that you can get hydrogen out of the surface, which we're proving that it is migrating, and put into a fuel cell and power to as a concept. We're also looking to do on-site ammonia plants, which can be used for energy, but also a big fertilizer need on the York Peninsula and around the area. It's a massive farming area, and they'd love to be able to get green fertilizer from a system like this. And also helium. we'd like to have a pilot program for the helium to start having a small bottling facility on site, bottle the helium and sell it into the domestic market. And there is no native in Australia production of helium anymore. Late last year, the Bayou Udan project in Northern Territory shut. So all helium use in Australia for MRIs, computer technology, and the like, it's all imported now. So we'd like to be able to test that market and show that it's some early commercialization.
And Neil, just finally, we mentioned it briefly last time we spoke, but people are becoming more aware now of the hydrogen industry and its importance moving forward. I think that was reflected in the, you know, the 16% rise in share price for you guys on the back of this announcement. But there seems to be a broader now understanding of what's coming.
Yes, it definitely is. I think the Gold Hydrogen team and other explorers looking for natural hydrogen around the world is getting world attention now. Global companies, exploration and producing companies, are now also looking for natural hydrogen and helium deposits similar to what we have. So it's getting attention in the energy industry from global energy companies wanting to look for this now. It's getting acceptance, which is a wonderful thing. And when you consider that natural hydrogen, all the assumptions based on Mali and other research we've done to date with our drilling for costs, could be produced at $1 a kilogram or less before transportation, and green hydrogen, which the world will need, and other forms of hydrogen, but their cost is approximately $4 a kilogram at best before transportation. You can see why there would be global interest. And on the helium front, there is a shortage of helium worldwide. And when it's selling for $450 per 1,000 scuffs, you know, as a unit price, it's definitely commerciality opportunities there. So that's why I think we're getting global attention.
Neil, it sounds like it's all working to plan at the moment. Have a good Easter break and we'll speak after that.
Yeah, thank you very much, and look forward to chatting to you with further successful results in the coming up.